So good morning, good afternoon, good evening, everyone. Thank you very much for joining us today for this quick session about OASIS new search experience. First, let me just introduce the team. So this is me, Anas Sobeid, your training and consulting partner. I'm based in Dubai, covering the Middle East and Africa region. I'm really delighted to have my colleagues, Jean Ward, our OASIS product manager. I have Michelle Tomasi with us, also OASIS marketing manager. And we have Chris Hamilton. He's our user experience designer from the technology department. So to be honest with you, we were working heavily on the back end of OASIS previously to make sure that it is really stable and fulfilling all your needs. We do have like at least one or two releases every month where we focus to improve and enhance our experience. Now we thought that it's time to move forward and we need to start working on the front end. We need you really to experience something new, something different. What you are going to see in today's session is somehow some kind of enhancements that we did with your search experience. So I will be demoing a lot of features that we added recently, things related to advanced search page, the search results, and the shopping cart page. Please feel free to ask your questions and we will have some like around 10, 15 minutes at the end where I will be able to answer and the team will be able actually to answer your question. So by this, I will now switch to the online demo where I can start sharing the experience. Let me just go to the second screen here. Okay, so this is your OASIS. And by the way, you can test the experience yourself by going to the OASIS Play. And this will be available on our March. The official features will be available on our March 19th release. So basically you can have a look and feel from now, you can go and test and provide your feedback. And this is actually what we really need from you at this point to help and to enhance your experience with OASIS. So as you can see, there will be no change to the main page of OASIS. What we really did is we made a huge effort on the advanced search. So once you click on the advanced search, you'll find a lot of enhancements. So here, somehow we gave it some kind of cosmetic view or face, where here I can just like add the ISBN, EN, or ISSN number. Also, you'll find this about the regional restrictions, digital reprints, self-published. This will not be available as part of March 19 release, but this will be soon be there and will be added. But just remember that by March 19, we will automatically hide any ebooks content which is not available for your geographic restrictions. You know, if you're like library in a specific country and there's some kind of restrictions, you'll not be able to find those books. It will be by default applied, but hopefully later on the year, this will be like, you can make it on, off, just like to check what other books available for you, okay? Things also we did, we changed the author to contributor now. And in the contributor, you can find also the editors. So you can search by editors as well. Here you can easily, just like also in the publisher, we added the ability to add any specific publisher by just simply click or type plus. Or you can even remove the unwanted publishers by simply put minus before them. And I will demo this in just like a few minutes. And another thing also here, you can see that hopefully as part of the next release, hopefully you will find a lot of enhancements and awards and reviews will be available, but not on March 19. Hopefully throughout the year, we will enable those because we received a lot of feedback that people would like to see the awards and the reviews kind of option within the advanced search. So this is the main advanced search page. It is very, very simple here to come and search for anything. So for instance, I just wanna go for antibiotics and I wanna exclude a few publishers that I know that they are really not my type. So I can simply just put minus here. So I just want to exclude minus graphic, minus knowledge. And in this case, I'm forcing the system to remove them from the list of results. After doing this, I can, of course, add as many options as I want And when I'm done, I will hit search. Now, this is our next thing. So we also added and we enhanced the search results page, as you can see. We are now removing the split window, and we are giving you some kind of better view. In case you are wondering about the information of every title, you can simply just click on the title. We will add, we will open a window where you have a lot of information about it. So about the title details, the activity summary, the mark record, etc. So this will be part of this pop-up window once you click on any title from the list of results. Also, something new we did is basically now, as you can see, the status above the title. So if you added this to your list, to the shopping cart, etc., we'll just mention this and we'll show it to you. Also, the status, if this already sent to your ratifier for approval, this was canceled or whatever, you'll find it in red. So this is also another thing that we did. On all our results, as you can see, we will list everything, all the copies, all the different formats that we have. And also, we will just give you some kind of indication if this title is available for full download, for DDA, access to own. Those kind of things will be available here. So basically, you can find the information from the results page itself. This is also another great thing that we did. You can easily select any type of format that you wish from the beginning. So basically, I can just like select a specific ebook format in this case, where I can just easily select it and continue my work. Also, what we did is basically we added the express checkout here and add to cart. So from the beginning, I can just like immediately do the express checkout, or I can easily just add it to my cart, and then I can just go to my cart and process or do whatever I want with my titles. This is usually the main things here we did on the search results. In addition to that, we added these like three dots here where you can also access the add to cart. You can add it to your list. And this is also something new based on your and the feedback that we received so far. So basically, it is very easy to add it to a specific list. You can send it to some of your colleagues, by the way, and this will be hopefully available soon. So I can just like select any title. I can suggest it to one of my colleagues. I can add it to one of my lists. And if you do remember, you can easily just go and edit any order information from here. So those are the main things that we did on the search results page. So if I want to just go and do some kind of express checkout in this case, I can select and do the express checkout. And in this case, I can easily just like fill in the information I want. And by the way, with our new OASIS, you'll see that we defaulted the number of books to 1, as you can see. Of course, you have the option to just like increase and ask for as many copies as you want. You can fill in the information. And I think you all know that basically this kind of order information page is fully customizable. Our customer service colleagues will work with you where they can easily just go and do whatever you think that it is necessary for your library. So this is also part of the enhancements that we did. It is very, very easy, very straightforward, and you can just select whatever you want, the format you want, you can add the order information you want, and then when it's time to just like send the order to your ratifier, it is just easily, you can go and submit the order, and that's it. You'll easily just go and submit it. And by the way, when you are selecting a new book, which is not yet published, you can see this kind of message where we just like try to provide as many accurate information as we can when doing this. So this is basically how we can easily select titles, send it for ratification. And as you can see, it is much better than before, and it's very straightforward. What we also did is basically in the shopping cart, we gave you a similar kind of experience. So on your shopping cart, you'll find all the titles that you added. Again, I can select whatever I want in very easy, straightforward way. I can add the order information as per my library policy. And then when it's time, I can just go and select my orders to my ratifier. Another cool feature here is basically when you open, by the way, when you open the search results, we added this search within this page. So basically you can do another search, maybe you need to be more specific and you want to customize your search. So in this way, you'll have the option to somehow have a full control of how to deal with your list of results. Another thing also I would like to highlight here is basically when you add your title to your shopping cart, for instance, it is also very easy to just like export the list as an Excel, and or even you can just like download the mark record, save it, print it, add it to any folder or list that you already have. So those kind of things are really cool kind of features that we added to enhance your experience. So here I can easily just click on add to, and I can add it to any existing list I already created, or I can even create a new one, and then I can whatever put the things that I'm interested in my preferred list. So those kind of things we really did. And by the way, this is still work in progress. So we are counting on you. We are counting on your feedback. We really appreciate everything you can deliver, you can tell us, because this is for you guys. This is what we are trying to do here, is try to provide you the best experience. So we really appreciate if you can provide your feedback now or later. You can click on this form and you can fill in the form after trying it yourself. As I told you, it is already there. It is on OASIS Play, where you can just test it yourself before the official release of March 19. So by this, I think this is somehow everything I would like to show you during the live demo: the advanced search page, the list of results, and the shopping cart. Those are the three main things, and those will be the starting point with a lot of more enhancements that we are planning to do throughout the year. So I think, let me just see, Michelle, Jean, do you have anything to add before start officially taking the questions from the audience here?
Thanks, Anas. That was really great. The only thing I would add is, again, to reiterate that we would love your feedback. And if you provide feedback, if you're comfortable giving us your contact information, we really like to reach out to people. Sometimes we need to get more information based on your workflow or your comments. And so if you feel comfortable doing that, we really appreciate it so that we can follow up, give you more information, give you updates on things that you've told us.
Thank you very much, Jean. By this, I would like just to go back to my slides. And I think we can now, I can say that basically you can find a lot of information on our OASIS Live Guide. And also we created some kind of quick guide to the advanced search where you can easily just go and check, and you can even try things by yourself. And this is available already in OASIS Live Guide, and a copy or a link will be here. And also, as Jean mentioned, we really love to hear your feedback because this is very important to us. We have a roadmap, but of course, this can be changed according to your priorities and to the feedback that we are receiving from our customers. So please feel free to share your feedback with us, and we will do our best to really enhance your experience. By this, I can now open it for Q&A. Please just send your questions to all panelists via chat. And my colleague, Michelle, if you can, I don't know, if you already have some questions, you can share it with me and Jean at this point.
Sure. Thank you, Anas. So we have a question that came in. Can your discount be calculated before the order is sent?
Jean, I believe you can answer this question.
Yeah, absolutely. So it depends on exactly what you're ordering. If you are ordering eBook Central content, absolutely. We actually have an API built into the shopping cart, an express checkout experience that will call eBook Central and tell you exactly what your discount will be. It'll give you the best available based on your general discounts and your promotions that are in place. For other eBook providers, generally the discount is baked into the price, so you would already see that. For print, it really is a bit more complicated. It depends on what region you're in. So We would ask that you reach out to your customer service team and we'll see what is possible to display. But absolutely, for ebooks, it should already be doing that for everyone.
Thank you, Jean.
Thanks, Jean.
I can see another question, Michelle, is about the templates creation. So I believe that this will still be available on the new interface, right, Jean?
That's right, the templates for order information, absolutely.
Yep, so there will be no change, but we are just like enhancing the way how you can use it and how you can create it yourself. Thank you very much, Jean. Back to you, Michelle.
Sure. So another question came in, will the search automatically change on the 19th or is it an option to move to the new search? So it will automatically switch over.
That's right.
And there's a few asks to post those links in the chat. I will do that when we have about 5 minutes just so that the links don't get lost in the chat. But yes, I will post the links to the LibGuide and the quick search guide. And this recording will also be available on the LibGuide, the demo portion, in the coming weeks. So you'll have access to that as well. Can you still see a last received date in the details of a print book?
That's a good question. I believe so. I will say it was not intentionally removed, but we can have a look and make sure that it's there. So if you find that it's not there on the 19th, just know that it would be soon, but I believe it should already be there.
Can we opt not to create a new title when we find something that you don't have?
Yes, you are definitely not required to create a new title. And in fact, that is a really good point. In the very first release on March 19th, I don't believe you'll be prompted. If the question is around not wanting to ever be prompted, that is something that we could look at adding to individual settings. It's not something that we've thought about, but we'd love to hear more about it. So please do tell us more about the experience that you're having in the feedback, and we'll be in touch for sure.
Thank you. And the question is, what were the three sections of the demo again? So just to reiterate, the three pages that Anas showed were the advanced search, the search results page, and the shopping cart.
And to that point, Michelle, I think I saw a question about the difference between the express checkout and the shopping cart. And I did want to speak to that a little bit. So in the legacy site, you have to kind of go through either the express checkout or you go to the cart and then do express checkout. We have essentially combined those steps. So if you're in search results and you click express checkout, it will take those three items and essentially take you to your cart with those three items checked. Anything else that's in your cart will not be checked. And at that point, you can choose to either check out the three items that you were interested in doing the express checkout, or you can check everything and just do everything that's in your cart at once.
Thanks, Jean. So there's a question about the regional restrictions. I wonder if you can clarify that, Jean. So the question is, you mentioned the regional restrictions option will be available a little bit later. So what I'm understanding is it will automatically hide, but I think they're asking about the toggle piece.
Yes, I'm happy to explain that. So that's correct. So on March 19th, when you do a search, any content that is regionally restricted, not available to you to purchase, will be hidden from your search results. That toggle represents the availability to essentially say, no, I do want to see content that's not available, in case you just want to verify why you can't find something, so that if you're not finding a title and you think, well, maybe it's just not available in my country, you can go back, flip that toggle, do the search again, and then it would show more like what it shows today. It would show the search result and it would say not available. So the initial release, those will be hidden and you won't be able to unhide them. The toggle that will be coming later will allow you to unhide them in case you just want to verify your search results.
Thanks, Jean, for that clarification. So there's another question. Someone is brand new to OASIS and just placed their first order last week. That's awesome. So they're wondering if we could show how to track the shipping of orders and if that's likely to change with the updates. So perhaps we can answer the second part of that. Is that going to change with the updates, tracking shipping of orders?
That shouldn't change. You should be able to see that if you go to the dropdown for order and go to order. You can do like a history report and put in when you place the order and it'll have some information. And if available, it populates actually a URL to UPS if it was shipped by UPS. That should not be affected at all by this result. The other thing that you can see when you place orders are a variety of statuses. So you can see firm order placed, and then you can see that gets updated when the item ships. The change there is that we are now able to show more than one status message at a time. In the legacy site, we have to have a hierarchy where we choose which one we believe is the most important to you, with firm order shipped being generally the most important one in that scenario. So if you have other history with that title, for instance, it was also in your DDA or it was added to a list by someone else, you would be able to see those multiple items in the new experience.
I just like received a few private questions that one person is asking about the multiple ISBN searches. So yes, they're still valid, and in the same box where you can see ISBN, you can just put your multiple ISBNs and you'll still do a search by multiple ISBNs, no problem at all. And also about the, can you share your list with other selectors? Yes, of course, as you saw that I can just like share the list with anyone, and I can also put it in any list that I already created. This will still there with no change, right, Jean?
That's right. That behavior is the same as it is today.
Great. And also about the seeing inside the book, yes, it is there. I'm really sorry if I couldn't show this clearly, but you can see when you add any or when you go to any book, and if the option is there, you can see this, see inside the book, this one, like this. So once you click on it, you can preview the book on the native platform. Back to you, Michelle, with the other questions.
Sure. So, Jean or Anas, can you clarify again the reason for changing author to contributor?
Sure. In some of our metadata, sometimes the editor is available for searching as well. And so we wanted to make sure that that was clear. It's not always the case. It's something that we want to work towards in the future. So this is kind of a nod to the future that we want to see in OASIS as well. So for now, it's essentially the same field. It's mainly the author. But the idea is that as OASIS grows and with some of the metadata that we have now, you'll be able to search the editor as well. And in future, other contributors to illustrators and anyone else that might be associated with a work.
Thanks, Jean. And just to confirm, are there any changes to the slip notification page?
So not with this release. This design that we're sharing with you, it only affects the search results and the checkout cart page. However, that is the end goal. So as we continue to work on the new experience throughout the year, we will eventually update this experience and design to other pages, including the slips pages. We don't have a date just yet for when slips will change, but we'll certainly let you know before they do.
Thank you, Jean. So we're getting a lot of great questions. I'm just trying to sort through them. Jean, did you see any in particular that we definitely want to call out in our last few minutes?
I saw one where somebody said, I notice if I place items in the cart in the existing profile, it doesn't show in the new profile and vice versa. Yes, so that's because the existing, the legacy design is on the what we call the production system, the live system where you're doing your ordering, and then the testing is in play. So on the 19th, you will only have this new search experience. Anything that's in your cart should remain in your cart. We would encourage you to maybe do a little export of that or save items to a list just in case. You never know, but everything should still be there in your cart, just with a new look to it on the 19th. And then anything you add will flow right through.
Thank you, Jean. So I'm just putting in the chat now the link to the OASIS LibGuide. And I'm also putting the link to the, it's a few pages document that kind of just walks you through those changes. So I've added that link to the chat as well, and you can also access it on the LibGuide.
And it's also worth mentioning, Michelle, that you can go and test it yourself, guys. Just go and use your same credential on the OASIS Play website, because I can see a lot of questions. Is this there? Is there, this is already there or not? This will disappear or not? So it's really better for you to just go and try it yourself. Most of the options will still there. It's just like some kind of enhancements on the interface, on the workflow, on the options available for you. But the main things will still there. And plus, we really need you to try yourself to provide your feedback, because based on your feedback, we really can progress and do a lot more to the things that it cares you or it really make a difference for you.
And Anas, is it possible for the questions that we didn't get to, is it possible for me to copy them out of the chat and then we could kind of post or provide a follow-up to the answers for everyone?
Yeah, sure. Because actually I can see like tens of questions.
Yeah,
this is really great. Yeah. And we are really sorry that we couldn't answer a lot of them because of the time and our like limits. So, but yeah, please just keep sending your questions, even to our email addresses, and we will do our best to really answer them. And the best way also to answer your questions is by providing your feedback as well. So you can just like send your question via the feedback, OASIS Play, and we'll make sure to answer them. Yeah, Michelle, anything you'd like to highlight here before we officially close this session?
I was just going to add, I believe after the session, attendees will automatically receive a link to fill out their feedback. Is that right?
Yep, exactly.
Okay. So after we conclude today, you will automatically get that form and you can add your feedback just from this initial experience, or if you have any additional questions, you can put those in there and we will see them.
And that's a different feedback form than the one that's live in OASIS Play. So if you noticed when Anas opened it, it had lots of questions where we were suggesting workflows for you to try to help guide your feedback. The one that we are providing at the end of this webinar is literally just a box for you to tell us all your feelings. So it's a little bit easier. And if you were intimidated by the one in the OASIS Play, don't worry about it. Like, fill out what you feel comfortable filling out. And again, we just encourage you to give us your email address so that we can reach out if we need clarification or need to answer anything directly.
Thank you, Jean, for that clarification.
Yeah, I think, Michelle, it's 8:30, and this will be the end of our quick session for today. Thank you all for joining us. Hopefully, you found this useful. And again, don't forget that once we close this meeting, you'll have this pop-up window where you need to click on continue, and you'll be guided to the feedback form where you can just like ask any question you want, and we will make sure to answer them all. Don't worry. So again, many thanks for everyone. Thanks, Jean. Thanks, Michelle. Thanks, Chris. And thanks to every like 300 plus people were with us today. And we look forward to meeting you again in our next training sessions. Thank you.
Thank you, Anas. And thank you everyone for your interest and enthusiasm.
Thank you, everyone. Enjoy the rest of your day.